Hello everyone and good day. This is Dr. Edward Padama and this time we are going to discuss another topic under our series Practical Research 1 for High School Students. Specifically, yung pag-uusapan natin ngayong araw na ito ay may kinalaman doon sa tinatawag nating data analysis used in qualitative research. Ulitin natin, data analysis used in qualitative research. So, in a nutshell, ang pag-uusapan natin dito, papaano nyo ba dapat i-analyze ang data na na-collect ninyo kapag ang research ninyo ay qualitative research. Tandaan ninyo, bago tayo magsimula, magkaiba ang analysis o data analysis ng quantitative research sa qualitative research. Kaya meron tayong video ngayon dito na pag-uusapan natin papaano ba itong proseso ng data analysis sa qualitative at ano yung iba't ibang klase ng pwede nyong gamitin na data analysis method. Bago tayo magsimula, imbitahan ko ulit kayo na tulungan ang ating YouTube channel by clicking subscribe. Ang YouTube channel po natin is Doc Ed Padama, and our TikTok account, which is also has the same name doon sa YouTube channel natin na Doc Ed Padama. Both of these channels have videos that can help you in your questions, inquiries regarding research writing hanggang sa research defense. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Ngayon, punta na tayo sa ating talakayan ngayong araw na ito, data analysis in qualitative research. Simulan natin sa definition ng data analysis. Pag sinabi nating data analysis, specifically sa qualitative research, ito ay ang proseso ng paghahanap sa quantitative, gumagamit sila ng numeric value. Dito, ang hahanapin ninyo, ang dadaanan ninyo, ang babasahin ninyo, ay hindi tabulated data. Hindi siya naka-table. Wala siyang numeric value. Dito, hahanapin nyo yung similarities ng mga sagot ng respondents ninyo. So, again, this is defined as the process of systematically searching and arranging the interview transcripts, the answers of the respondents, manuscripts, the same as the transcript, observation notes, or other non-textual materials that the researcher accumulates to increase the understanding of the phenomenon or yung area ng investigation ninyo sa research ninyo under ng qualitative. So again, this is the concept behind data analysis sa qualitative research. Next, so analyzing qualitative data entails reading a large amount of transcripts, manuscripts. Sabi ko kanina, earlier, you are going to look for similarities or differences and subsequently categorizing. Pag nakita nyo na yung similarities, differences, yung palaging lumalabas, you're going to categorize them and then eventually develop a theme. So, usually yung traditional way of doing this or data analysis was if you have your manuscript, like on your left side, you have to read all and go through all of the transcripts and then you have to code them. So, in this case, naka-color code siya. Anong ibig sabihin kapag ganitong color, kapag ganyang color, and so on and so forth. Okay? So, that's called coding, categorizing. Okay, we're going to discuss that later on in our video na medyo mas comprehensive para alam ninyo kung ano yung mga steps and process under coding. Okay, the next one, conventionally or traditionally, this is how it was done. Researchers cut and paste or use color or colored pens to categorize data. Maliban dito, dun sa paggamit ng highlighter, before, kasi meron ng bagong paraan ngayon eh, before, they even cut the pieces of the transcript that they feel that is part or relevant dun sa research nila and then nilalagay nila sa folder. So that's how they categorize conventionally before the before the availability of the applications na meron ang pwedeng gumawa niyan ngayon. Okay? Now, coding. Coding is one of the data analysis method that you can use if you are conducting a qualitative research. Ulitin natin, one of the data analysis method that you can use will be coding. So, there are different processes and steps ng coding na pag-uusapan natin ngayong araw na ito. Now, coding, in general, this is not yet the steps. Coding or categorizing the data is an important stage in qualitative data analysis process. Coding and data analysis are not synonymous. Yung coding process and data analysis is not the same. So, coding is part of data analysis. Again, coding is just a part of data analysis. Coding is the process of organizing your data, sequencing your data, para makapag-arrive kayo doon sa analysis, doon sa resolution ninyo, doon sa conclusion ninyo. So, again, FYI, these terms, yung coding and data analysis, are not synonymous with each other, but they are related. Okay, so through coding, though coding is a crucial aspect, sabi ko kanina, it's a part of qualitative data analysis process. So, yun yung in-explain ang definition natin ngayon. Now, coding merely involves subdividing, hinahati-hati niya, yung nasa manuscript ninyo. Subdividing a huge amount of raw information or data and subsequently assigning them into categories. So, ulit-ulitin natin to para maging familiar kayo doon sa process. Yung raw data ninyo na nakolekta ninyo from your respondents, ika-classify nyo ngayon yan. So, hahanapin nyo ngayon ano bang ibig nyo sabihin kapag sinabi nyo ganito, kapag sinabi nyo ganyan, kapag sinabi nyo ganyan. So, lalagyan nyo muna ng label yon. And then, after that, you categorize. And from categorizing, mag-a-arrive na kayo doon sa theme. That's the coding process. Okay? So, again, coding merely involves subdividing a huge amount of raw information or data and subsequently assigning them into categories and then coming up with a core category, or ang tawag natin doon is theme. Core category is the last part ng process ng coding. At the end of the coding process, makakapag-arrive ka na ng theme, and that is where you can already form your conclusion based on the theme that you have arrived at sa data analysis ninyo. Okay, now, so, from the transcript, makikita nyo kanina, on the left side, meron tayong illustration na yung manuscript ninyo, yung transcript ninyo, it's highlighted or even cut, and then after that, it is categorized. So, for every category, it goes into a folder, which on the second illustration, all of these codes, all of these answers are already placed into one category. So, there can be several categories. So, magkakaiba siguro sila ng sagot, pero ito lang din naman yung sinasabi nila. Pinagsasama yung mga codes na yon. And then, after that, you're going to develop a category for those codes. Okay? And then, the next part would be, ayan na, yun yung core category na. So, that's eventually the process from the categories. From different codes, you were able to develop three categories, and then from these three categories, you were able to synthesize them into one main core category or theme. Okay? So makikita nyo, hindi siya pyramid, inverted pyramid from general to specific. Okay? And then in simpler terms, coding are just tags or labels for allocating identified themes or topics from data compiled in the study. The same discussion that we had from a general raw data, you label them, gagawa nyo sila ng code, yun yung labeling, and then after that, kakategorize nyo yung mga labels na nakuha ninyo, and then after categorizing the label, then you come up with a core category or ang tawag natin doon is theme. Okay, next. So, earlier, nakita ninyo this is the conventional type of coding when the software or application was not yet available. But right now, at the bottom part of your screen, you can already see a desktop, a screen showing a software that already has color codes, and then eventually from color codes, pwede nyo nang store yung mga codes na yon into categories, and then eventually you're going to analyze that and arrive at a specific theme. So pwede na siyang pwede na siyang computerized. Okay, so there are already applications for that, and later on I'm going to give you the specific name of the software that can do this. Okay, traditionally coding was done manually with the use of colored pens to label, categorize data, and subsequently cutting and sorting the data. Now, given the advancement of software technology in our time right now, electronic methods of coding data are increasingly used by qualitative researchers. And specifically, itong tinatawag nating software technology na ito, a specific example is in vivo. In vivo is one of the computer-assisted qualitative data analysis software, or CAQDAS, developed by QSR International based in Australia, Melbourne, Australia. This is the world's largest qualitative research software developer. So this is the name of the company and the name of the product or the software that can do this. So if you're interested, you can look into that. I am just not sure if this is a free software, or you need to pay for the software. Okay, next. So again, coding is done repeatedly. It is not just done one time. You need to go through the codes, the categories, and then eventually double check if your theme is correct in order to remove bias, in order to cover all of the bases, to make sure na lahat nakita ninyo, na isama ninyo, na include ninyo. So coding is done repeatedly until major patterns arise. Meron pa ulit-ulit na sinasabi, magkakaiba yung salita pero isa lang yung idea. So that's still part of the coding process that will fall under the first category. Okay, yung open coding, mamaya i-discuss din natin ulit yan. You can visualize coding by thinking of an essay. So, ang illustration yan, parang gumawa, hindi gumawa, merong nag-submit sa inyo ng essay, and then you're going to go through the essay on a piece of paper with you cutting the sentences with a scissor and filing them under a folder with a certain classification para makita ninyo kung ano yung mga umuulit-ulit doon sa essay na yon. Coding has three types. Ito na, dito na nagsisimula yung tinatawag nating coding process. There are three elements of the coding process in which succeeding types are more centrally organized than the preceding type. Okay? So, makikita nyo dito yung illustration mamaya. Paano ba related itong mga elements na ito at paano nagkakaroon ng organizing and sequencing under the coding process. Ito na yung coding process. So makikita nyo dyan, yung sinasabi niyang type, I'd like to call it elements because they are relevant and related to each other. You have the open coding, actual coding. Actual is centered or revolves around. Okay? The open coding, actual coding, and then selective coding. So how do we explain this? In a nutshell, the general description of the coding process or open coding, these three elements. In a nutshell, open coding is when you take textual data, raw muna, yung isinubmit pa lang, textual data and break it up into discrete parts. So ito yung sinasabi natin, ano ba yung palaging lumalabas doon sa mga sinasabi sa raw data, sa manuscript, sa transcript, sa notes na nakita ninyo? Igo-group nyo sila ngayon. Yun yung open coding. Ika-categorize nyo sila ngayon. Okay? So that's the first one. And then actual coding is when you draw connections between your codes. So sabi natin kanina, ito lumabas, ito lumabas. Ay, ito pareho lang. Pagsamahin natin. And then, lagyan natin ng category na ganyan. So, meron dalawang magkapareho. And then, over that, lalagyan nyo na sila ng category. Okay? So, that is what you call axial coding. Axial coding is when you draw connections between your codes. And then, the last one is selective coding. This is when you select one central category, isang category, and then connects all of the codes from your analysis and then captures the essence of your research. So, ano ang relevance nitong mga sinabi under this category doon sa research na ginagawa ninyo? So, this is where you come up with yung tinatawag nating core category or theme. Theme that is relevant, related to the research that you are conducting. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng mga nakita ninyo na magkakapareho na ito under this core category doon sa research ninyo? So, again, to illustrate, you start with open coding. So, on the right side, you break your data into discrete parts and create codes to label them. Create codes, labeling lang ang open coding. Magbabasa kayo ano yung pare-pareho, then you label them. Okay, so sinabi niya ito tungkol sa unemployment, ito natanggal siya sa trabaho, ito yung mahirap pumanap ng trabaho. So, all of them are categorized under unemployment. Okay, so after open coding, axial coding now is when you begin to draw connections between these codes. So, pagsasama-samahin ninyo and then you create a category like what I said, all of what they replied or answered doon sa inyong instrument, ay pare-pareho naman, they are similar, then formulate a category for that those particular answers. Anong pwede nyong gamiting category for all of these similar answers that you were able to gather from open coding? So that's actual coding. Okay, then from concepts to categories, you now formulate your theme under selective coding. So on the right side of your screen, you connect all your categories together around one core category. So if you have, you were able to formulate three categories, diba? From labeling, tapos na nailagay nyo na sila doon sa iba't ibang category. And then from these three categories, sa dami ng mga sagot na yon, meron pwedeng i-connect na isa lang doon sa tatlong category. This is what we call selective coding or arriving at a theme. You connect all your categories together around one core category. So, you form what we call the coding process. Diba? Nandiyan yung open coding, axial coding, selective coding, and then you start with the concept, categories, and eventually arrive at a theme, and then the description is on the right side of your screen. Okay, and then concept mapping is another method that you can use in data analysis for qualitative research. Paano naman ang concept mapping? On the left side of your screen, you can already see a diagram. So concept mapping, basically, the main idea behind this is just a diagram, a visual organization and representation of knowledge. It shows concepts and ideas and the relationship among these concepts. So, meron kayong maraming nakita na lumabas doon sa raw data ninyo. You put them all together and you try to organize them in a way that at a glance, kapag tinignan yan ng panel ninyo or the expert who is going to check your research, they can readily see the summary, the idea behind your research. So parang it's already a summary of the abstract of your research. So makikita nyo na dyan, not just the relationships of the information, but also the solutions. That's why on the left side of your screen, you can already see evidences, cause, and solutions. And then under those categories, they are broken down into different or more specific areas. Again, this does not just include a specific area. This already includes the concept of the whole research that you are conducting. So you organize your data in this manner. Okay, you create a concept map by writing keywords, sometimes enclosed in shapes. Kagaya niyan, pwede siyang circle, box, pwedeng cloud shape, and so on and so forth. And then drawing arrows, which represents the connection and relationship of these concepts or ideas in the whole research. So be careful with your arrow. So meron bang kailangan na arrowhead? Wala pang arrowhead. Pag walang arrowhead is, ano yan? Two-way yan. Pag may arrowhead, dun lang siya papunta. Okay? And then you add a short, brief explanation. A brief explanation by the arrow, pwede naman sa ilalim ng mismong diagram, and then you just label the arrow to explain how the concepts are related to each other. So, this is like in the quantitative research. Kapag may table, at the bottom is a brief explanation of the table, but you do not explain all of the data. You just explain the highest, the lowest, or yung middle score. In this case, sa qualitative naman, if you have this diagram, you just explain the main categories and then briefly discuss the reason or the cause for these categories. And paano sila nagkakaroon ng ano, ng relationship with each other. So this is by Joseph Novak. Okay? So basically, this is how you go through data analysis in qualitative research. So I hope you were able to learn something from our discussion today. And again, I would like to thank everyone of you who watch this video. We have more research writing videos available in our YouTube channel. So just go to your YouTube browser and look for Doc Ed Padama. And don't forget to click subscribe. And then you can also check out my TikTok account, which I answer inquiries, questions in short video formats like 1 minute to 3 minutes. Okay, and then you are going to see videos on the sides of your screen. I'm sure this will help you with regard to your research writing hanggang sa research defense ninyo. Marami pong salamat sa inyong lahat. And again, stay safe and God bless. I will see you on our next video. Bye!